Hi friend, it's Ron from CamMastery.com, where you can go to learn how to make great videos with Camtasia. This is a free lesson Friday, which means you get a free lesson right from my Camtasia Mastery course. If you want to get the entire course, you can head over to CamMastery.com/store and pick up that course. Now, onto the video.
I now want to look at audio points. And most of the time when I'm using audio points, I'm using it to fade things in and out. So let's look at a couple of scenarios where we can create our own audio points and fade things the way we want. One way to do this is to look at a section. So I see here, this is probably a little place, I don't know if you see this down here, I'm gonna zoom in, where I'm breathing in. You can see like this little, it looks like I'm probably doing like a, you know, just a breathe in. So what I might wanna do here is I'll click on the track, and I can see here that I have that green line that's indicating that's where the audio is. I can double click right there and create a point, and double click there and create a point, and then a little bit over here, and a little bit over here. And then now that I have these four points, I can grab this and I can drag this all the way down to zero, so you won't hear me breathing in. Okay, so that's one way that I can do that. Just double click to create those audio points. Now I'm going to undo that because I want to show you an easier way to do this. I can just highlight this area, and then if I grab this bar and drag it down, now you can see it created four audio points for me, and it took that section all the way down to zero. So that's a nice, easy way to get those audio points in. Double click if you need one right there on the timeline, or highlight and do what you need to that way. So usually I'm going to use this for fading in and out, like for music. So let me zoom back out to about here, and let me insert a track below. And we'll grab some music from the library, music tracks, and I like Firefly. So I'll just grab that and drag that down here. So let's say that I want this video to start, and then Firefly is going to be in the background. Now I want to fade this in, and what I can do is I can just highlight this section, audio effects, fade in, right? And then it fades that part in. Now I might not want it to fade in that quickly. That's a pretty quick fade in. I might want it to fade in a little more gradually. So you can see I can grab this and drag it up or down. Take that point, and you can see I can drag it horizontally, and I can drag it vertically if I need to. So I want to keep it right around the 100% right now just to show you, just to try and keep things at the same level. But maybe I need a more gradual one over time. So I might say maybe I need, how long is this? You know, 3.5 seconds of fade in. Okay, so sure. Say 3.5 seconds right around there. Technically 3:15, there we go. And I can grab this and just drag it over. So I'd usually use this fade in at the beginning before I start speaking. And then what I would do is while I'm speaking, I would want all of that to be a lower volume. So I would grab this and say, let's lower all of this. And the music isn't overtaking what I'm saying, so I'll drop that down a lot quieter. And then I'll want it to fade back in. Now the fade back in at this point is really, really quick. So what I'll do is I'll just scroll over a bit and yeah, that's really loud. So I'll take this and maybe I'll stretch it out to like here. Maybe I'll even start a little bit earlier where I'm at the end of my sentence and I want it to start swelling, you know, getting a little bit louder until I get to this point and then it's at its regular volume. So if I look at that again, I just have it low or further down while I'm speaking. When I'm done, I bring it back up. And you might use this like if you were doing some sort of sales video, you might have some music at the beginning, then somebody has something to say, so you slow it, you drop it down, and then you bring it back up when they're done talking. I would do the same thing at the beginning. This sudden drop in volume is really noticeable, so I wouldn't want to do that. Instead, what I would probably do in something like this is really remove the fade in that I have. So I'll go back to the beginning here. What I'll do is maybe I'll just drag this over. I don't need to fade it in there, but this part needs to fade out a little slower as I'm starting to speak, or maybe even stretch it out a little bit like this. So it's still playing, but then getting quieter just as I'm starting to speak. Now, another thing is if you create an audio point that you don't want, you can just right click that audio point and you can delete that one, or you can right click on one audio point and say remove all audio points. And that's basically a reset for the entire track. You could just say, oh, I messed it up far too much. Let's just reset the whole thing. Now, I don't typically do that. In fact, I'll undo that real quick. You know, you probably won't leave them all in there, but in that rare case where you say, yeah, I need to start from scratch, you can do that. Typically, though, if I need to start from scratch, I would maybe just grab the track from the media bin and drag it down, because then that's it. It started from scratch. So it's up to you however you want to handle it. But just want to show you that you can double click to create a new one. You can right click and delete one, delete them all, and then use your head. You know, how does it make sense for me to fade down while I'm talking? And then when I'm done, fade back in that music. And that's how we use audio points.